One question I get asked a lot is which program is best for your classroom, Pear Deck or Nearpod? Now, that's a tough question to answer, so I decided to bring on my friend Jake Miller from Educational Duct Tape to help us out.
What's up, Sam?
Hey, everybody.
So in this video, we'll finally be putting this question to rest, or not.
Yeah, I mean, probably not.
Whatever, that's not important. In this video, we'll be breaking it down for you.
Representing Nearpod, we have Sam Kary. Representing Pear Deck, we have Jake Miller.
Yes, apparently I'm here to represent Team Pear Deck, although I'm nearly as big of a fan of Nearpod.
Jake, if all you're gonna bring to this battle is corny jokes, then you're going down.
Ouch, yeah, that seemed a little personal there, Sam. But I did use Pear Deck in my classroom last school year, and all pun jokes aside, it was the MVP of the 2020 to 2021 school year for me.
The ability to combine elements of direct instruction, images, text, videos, and audio, along with a variety of types of interactivity, is huge for any type of classroom, remote, concurrent, or in person. But my favorite part is that you can do it synchronously, keeping all students on the same slide and the same content and the same question at the same time. Or you could do it asynchronously, allowing them to work at their own pace or even at different times entirely.
Not bad, Jake. That all sounds pretty good. But let me tell everybody out there why you would want to be using Nearpod. Like Pear Deck, Nearpod helps you make every single one of your lessons interactive so that you can hear from 100% of your students 100% of the time. Since students are consistently answering questions throughout a Nearpod lesson, you'll have your finger on the pulse and you'll know exactly what's happening at any time in your classroom. So it's a really powerful formative assessment tool. And in addition to helping you make your presentations interactive, Nearpod also provides teachers with interactive content tools. For example, rather than presenting just a boring static video for your students, Nearpod's gonna let you make that video interactive. So you can embed little checks for understanding with multiple choice questions and open-ended questions right into that video. Like Pear Deck, Nearpod can also be used for live teaching or asynchronous student-paced lessons. And once the lesson is finished, you can go back and check reports to see exactly how individual students responded, as well as how your whole class did overall. And that's gonna help you be able to know what you need to reteach and what your students have already learned. How are you feeling about Pear Deck now, Jake?
Whoa, Sam. I'm feeling okay. You made some good points there, but let's dig in a little bit deeper to the way students can respond in Pear Deck, and then I'll show you how I'm feeling.
All right, show me.
First up, Pear Deck allows you to ask your students multiple choice questions. As you can see, the slide can also include other information like text, images, videos, and even audio from you, the teacher. Your students can select one answer to the question, and on the projector, you can show the result. In the premium version, you have access to a teacher dashboard that lets you see which student answered which way and look at everybody's answers. So yeah, I'm feeling pretty confident about Pear Deck.
That's great and all, Jake, but you can do pretty much the exact same thing in Nearpod, plus these extra two additions. First, in Nearpod, student responses can be automatically graded. Second, in the free version of Nearpod, you can see which students responded, and that's a paid feature in Pear Deck.
Ooh, good points. While I do love the multiple choice option in Pear Deck, it is a bummer that they don't auto grade in there. And you're right, you can't connect individual answers to the students that gave them in the free version during the lesson, but you can download a spreadsheet of all the responses after the lesson and see who gave what answer. Still though, I think Nearpod might get the edge in this category.
And don't forget, Nearpod also has a polling question type.
Okay, now you're just gloating.
And you can set multiple choice and polling questions as multiple select.
Yeah, in Pear Deck, students can only select one answer. So I do think they're winning a little bit in the way multiple choice functions there.
Point Sam.
But let's look at the second question type in Pear Deck, which is a text response question. I love that during a live lesson, I can limit the amount of time that students have to answer those questions. I also really like the ability to anonymously share those student responses on the projector for their classmates to see. But my favorite part is that in the paid version of Pear Deck, I can actually give the students feedback right there within Pear Deck on their responses.
How about them apples, Sam?
Body blow. You're right, Nearpod doesn't have a great way of giving students immediate feedback live in a lesson. So I have to admit, that's definitely a valuable feature of Pear Deck. But did I mention in Nearpod, students can also respond by recording audio?
I was hoping you weren't gonna bring that up. That is a fantastic additional response option that taps into UDL, or Universal Design for Learning. That means that the students can choose to respond with audio or with text. And while I wish that feature was in Pear Deck 2, I think that Pear Deck's teacher feedback option, which Nearpod doesn't have, makes this one a draw.
Speaking of draw, drawing questions in Nearpod are pretty amazing. With the Draw It tool, I can add a drawing slide that allows me to upload any background I want. So I can put an image and have students annotate an image. I can even screenshot text and put text in the background to have students draw on top of, or I can upload a PDF. And Nearpod also has loads of different activity templates that are already made with graphic organizers and all sorts of different things that you can add as a background for students to be able to draw on top of. UDL for the win.
Oh, Sam, sorry to interrupt you.
Wait, are you really sorry?
Okay, not really. But what I was about to say was that you can do that in Pear Deck too.
These drawing slides are a great formative assessment tool. And I love that in Pear Deck, not only can I see the students' responses as they're drawing them, but I can also overlay those responses on top of one another, which often looks like a mess, but in math class, it's really neat for seeing if students are drawing the right point or graphing the correct equation or maybe labeling the right spot on a map.
That's pretty cool, but can students add pictures to their drawings in Pear Deck?
No, you can't.
Well, they can with Nearpod.
Okay, I'm going to go ahead and change the subject on that one.
I also really like in Pear Deck the draggable slides. I can add up to 6 different icons and have the students drag them around the screen to certain locations, and then I can look at them individually or overlay them, or I can even look at them one icon at a time to see if students are understanding or not.
Okay, Pear Deck wins that one. There's no draggable slide in Nearpod, but you can sort of replicate the experience by having students circle things on the draw it slide. Still, it's not quite the same, and I do like those draggables.
Hey Sam, could you say that Pear Deck wins that one just one more time for me? I wanna hear it one more time.
Sorry, no.
But you made a good point there about how you could probably reach the same pedagogical outcome with a drawing slide. But what's really important here is the teaching and learning.
Just because you're using big words like pedagogy does not mean you're gonna win this battle, Jake.
Debatable, Sam. By the way, I should point out that the drawing and draggable slides are both part of the premium version of Pear Deck. However, there is a hack that you could use to access drawing and draggable slides in the free version. And if you're curious about how to do that, let me know down in the comments and I'll reply and give you those steps.
On that note, while some of the question types are only premium features in Pear Deck or free with a hack, all of the question types are free in Nearpod.
True, but there are a few limitations to the free version of Nearpod as well. Before we get to those though, let's cover the last few question and response types.
Pear Deck also provides a number response question. And you might wonder, well, Jake, why do I need a number response question if there's already a text response question? Can't they just type the numbers into the text? Well, technically they can, but in the number response question, those numbers go onto a box and whisker plot, which you could show on your projector, which is a really cool way to be able to compare students' answers and see the range of answers between students.
That's pretty good. Nearpod doesn't have that option, but it does have a few features that Nearpod does not. You ready? By the way, if you're finding this video helpful, then be sure to smash that like button. And you can also show your support for the video by sharing it with other teachers that you know.
Ooh, do you mean smash? Like how I'm smashing you in this debate?
No.
Oh, okay. Well, while you're showing your support for this video, let us know down in the comments, which one do you prefer? Pear Deck or Nearpod?
Jake Miller or Sam Kary? All right, let's get back to all those features that Nearpod has that Pear Deck does not. Number one, drag and drop fill in the blank activities where students drag words to show where they would fit in a paragraph as a way to practice key vocabulary. There are also matching activities where students can match pictures to texts or a word to its definition. And just like I showed you with the Draw It tool, there are loads of pre-created templates that you can take, edit, and use as you'd like for a matching activity. And there's a collaborative bulletin board where students can post their responses and see each other's responses, sort of like a mini built-in Padlet. Plus interactive video. It used to be that you had to go to Edpuzzle as a separate program to make all videos interactive, and don't get me wrong, I still love Edpuzzle. But now you can make interactive videos in Nearpod. And it's not just that you can make interactive videos, there's also a huge archive of pre-created interactive videos. You can even do things like upload your own video tutorial from Loom or Screencastify and make that interactive. And time to climb? Game-based learning directly embedded in Nearpod? Boom!
Yeah, those are all points in Nearpod's column for sure. But I will say they're not impossible in Pear Deck, just not as convenient. That's because I've left out one other interactivity type in Pear Deck, and that is website slides. With website slides, you can embed just about any kind of web content into your Pear Deck. That means you can embed Ed puzzles for video activities, Padlets for collaboration, or Flippities for things like the matching pairs you were talking about.
I agree. I do appreciate that you can embed web content in Pear Deck, and that is a good way to get full functionality out of a program like Edpuzzle while still using Pear Deck, I guess. But you can also do that in Nearpod. And Nearpod has special integrations with FET simulations, Microsoft Sway, virtual field trips, Flipgrid, and 3D content.
Yep, each of those things are great, and while you could do them in Pear Deck, it's much easier in Nearpod. However, I've got something on my sleeve the teachers are really gonna love. And that's that mid-lesson, you could switch from synchronous to asynchronous or vice versa and do it multiple times during the lesson.
Oh yeah?
Yeah. This past school year, I really love that I could start my lessons with students all at the same pace, maybe for a quick check for understanding or entrance ticket, but then I could set them all loose to work at their own pace on the content. I also like that I could pull them all back to teacher pace at any point in the lesson in case I noticed maybe a widespread misconception with my students. And that toggling from synchronous to asynchronous and back again is something that you cannot do in Nearpod, can you, Sam?
That's a good point. You can run synchronous or asynchronous lessons in Nearpod, but you can't switch mid-lesson. And that's definitely advantage Pear Deck.
Yeah, I like that part where you said advantage Pear Deck. I think you're gonna be saying that a few more times coming up, Sam. You know, I mentioned earlier widespread misconceptions in my students' understanding and the ability to help the students with them right there in the moment. I also like that in Pear Deck, I could add questions on the fly. Yeah, good teachers plan times for formative assessment during a lesson, but they also identify unplanned times during a lesson when they need a quick check for understanding. And I like that in Pear Deck, I can add questions on the fly that might be multiple choice, number, text response, drawing, or draggable, even in the free version.
Adding those spontaneous checks for understanding mid-lesson is super important. And you can do that in Nearpod as well, but you can't add any of the question types. You can only add a true-false question, a draw-it question, or an open-ended question mid-lesson. But now you can pull up a mini digital whiteboard mid-lesson to just quickly reteach a concept if you needed to do that. Plus, one thing you can't do in Pear Deck, in Nearpod, you can add a website slide on the fly as well.
Ah, yes, that's a great one. I could definitely see myself spontaneously adding a quick Blue Kit game or quizzes game mid-lesson right into a Nearpod lesson, and you can't do that in Pear Deck.
Wait, what about GimKit? Another battle video?
That's actually a really good question, Sam. So let us know down in the comments, what other EdTech app showdown do you want to see? I will say that the Pear Deck Premium plan, which is super affordable, also offers two really awesome additional features. First off, student takeaways. If you're a Google user, you can automatically generate these student takeaways Google Docs that send out to the students and feature the original slides and the students' responses to those slides. These are really great for notes or review documents.
Okay. You can run reports in Nearpod, but those reports are mostly teacher-facing. There isn't really a great way to use those student responses for review in the same way that you can with Pear Deck.
Uh-huh. Yeah, right? Also, the other great thing that you get in the premium version is Reflect and Review. With Reflect and Review, teachers can look at students' responses after the lesson and offer them feedback then, and the students can go back and see that feedback and review the lesson whenever they want.
Wow, that is significant. A big shortcoming of Nearpods is that it's not really all that great for giving students individualized feedback.
Yeah, speaking of feedback, here's a little feedback for you, Sam. I'm winning.
Yeah, that remains to be seen. Let's see what the audience thinks in the comments below.
Not to hit you while you're down, Sam, but I got another one for you.
How about the difference between the way Pear Deck and Nearpod interact with Google Slides or PowerPoint? In Nearpod, the add-on for adding interactivity into your Google Slides is now a paid-only feature. And adding questions into your slides literally adds new slides after the existing slides, meaning you have one slide with the content and a slide following it with the question. Let's compare that to the way it works in Pear Deck. In Pear Deck, you can add your interactivity right into your existing slides. For example, when you ask students a question, they will see your slide right alongside the question that you're asking them. Whereas in Nearpod, that question slide will come after the slide with your content on it. I think that difference makes for a more fluid user experience for both the teacher when they're designing the lesson and for the students when they're going through the lesson. I also think it means that I am beating up on Sam right now.
All right. Let's not overstate things here. Winning the battle does not mean you won the war. But I do also prefer the way that the Pear Deck add-on works here. And if you're someone who has a lot of pre-created lesson slides that you just want to add some quick interactivity to, then you might want to use Pear Deck's add-on.
Wait. Did you just admit that something in Pear Deck is better?
Maybe.
I think it's clear that both tools are awesome and that each has some features that the other doesn't have.
Now that is true.
One thing that I want to point out before we wrap up are some key differences between the two free versions.
In Pear Deck, you can have unlimited lessons of unlimited sizes, have unlimited numbers of students participate in them, and have unlimited number of lessons running simultaneously. In Nearpod, on the other hand, you can have up to 100 megabytes of lessons, each of them containing up to 40 megabytes of content, having up to 40 students participate in them, and have only one of those lessons running at a time. And so in reality, while Nearpod is an awesome tool, it means that if you're going to use it a lot, you might need the paid version.
Okay, I do agree with that last point. But in the free version of Nearpod, you can see students' names on responses and you can choose from any of the response types. Oh, and there's an app. Did I mention there's a Nearpod app?
Well played. So who wins?
Neardeck?
Pearpod?
Yeah, I'm not sure there's a clear winner here.
I think the winner is the teacher and their students.
Who am I kidding? I do want to make sure that I won. So be sure to write Sam Kary won the Nearpod Pearpod debate in the comments below.
Well, yeah. I want to win too. So it's J-A-K-E. You know, for when you're typing in the comments to tell everybody that I won, J-A-K-E.
On this, Jake and I agree. No matter what tool you end up using, you're pretty much guaranteed to make your lessons more effective, interactive, and engaging for your students.
And that's great news. By the way, if you like the idea of comparing educational technology tools to see which is best for you, check out more comparisons in my book, Educational Duct Tape, and my podcast called Educational Duct Tape.
Jake, I love your podcast, especially that one on May 20th, 2021. Wow, the guest you had on that episode was just so insightful and interesting to listen to. I absolutely love that episode.
Wasn't that you?
I think it was. Thanks so much for watching this video to the end. If you found it helpful, be sure to hit the like button and share it with other teachers that you know. And since Jake plugged his podcast and his book, I'm going to plug my free How to Teach with Technology starter kit. You can get it at newedtechclassroom.com/starterkit, and it will teach you everything you need to know about getting started taking a strategic approach to using technology in your classroom.
And be sure to tell us in the comments, which one is your preferred tool, Pear Deck or Nearpod?
Vote for me!